What we basically need to do in this example, ladies and gentlemen, is if you guys are having trouble, especially when you're doing a problem like this, my recommendation, you can always break this apart into negative 2 times the cube root of negative 8 times the cube root of x to the 6th times the cube root of y to the 8th. You do not have to do this. But I know, understand, a lot of times when you guys have multiple variables, multiple numbers, and so forth, sometimes it just might be helpful to think about this as 3 different sets of problems, but then with the product. So the cube root is saying what number multiplied by itself 3 times gives us negative 8. Now remember, we know that when we're talking about even root, square root, fourth root, sixth root, we cannot take the even root of a negative number. But for the odd root, we can. So first thing we want to look at, is 8 a cubed number? Yes. What number multiplied by itself 3 times gives us positive 8? 2. So if it's a negative 2, would that give us negative 8? Yes. So I do negative 2. First answer is negative 2. The next answer, the cube root. Again, we're looking at a term that's to undo the cube root, you guys would agree with me that the cube root of x cubed is equal to x. Agree with me? So all we want to do is be able to write this variable. So write this variable so it's raised to the third power. Yes? So I can do that by rewriting this as the cube root of x to the squared cubed. Because remember the power rule in exponents that we talked about? 2 times 3, when you raise a power to a power, you multiply them. 2 times 3 is the same thing as 6, right? Okay. And then this one, we can do that. We know that gives us 6. I can't multiply a number by 3 to give us 8, correct? So I'm going to have some extras. I know this gives me 6. But then I'm going to have 2 more left over. Would you guys agree with me that if I was going to simplify that radicand, it would give me, oh, I'm sorry, that's y. It'd give me y to the 8th. Y2 raised to the 3rd is y to the 6th. Y to the 6th times y squared is y to the 8th. So now, cube roots. Those undo each other. So now I'm left with a positive 4 times x squared. Here, I have a y squared is out. However, can you take the cube root of that y squared? So that's going to remain under the radical. So your final answer is 4x squared y squared times the cube root of y squared. And that's going to be your final answer. Anybody have any clarifying questions? Yes?
So in the last